Hello everyone, I'm Xiang. I'm an application engineer from Texas Instruments. Today I'm going to give you an introduction to the SEPIC converter and have a design guide to a SEPIC converter using the LM3481 controller. So what is a SEPIC controller? It stands for single-ended primary inductor converter. It's a converter topology that can regulate output voltage higher or lower than the input voltage, which make it suitable for automotive application and other application with wide input variation range. So for this topology, it has two inductor and one capacitor components as the energy exchange and storage components. But the two inductor in this topology can be replaced by a single couple inductor. By using a single couple inductor, it can save the solution size and the component counts. Also, it lowers the requirement of the inductance and mitigate the oscillation in the circuit. So for design a SEPIC, we are going to use TI's LM3481 controller as the example. So the LM3481 controller is a very high efficient and flexible controller. It can not only use as a SEPIC controller, but can also use as a boost and flyback controller. It has a wide VIN range and it's automotive grade ready, and it's fully supported by Webbench. For this design example of SEPIC converter, we are going to use these following specs, which has an input voltage of 4.5 volts to 20 volts and has an output of 12 volts at 1 amps and has a switching frequency at 500 kilohertz. So to start the design, let's go to the Webbench page. So Webbench is a useful and powerful tool to starting the SEPIC design. It can generate the schematic, give you the selection of the suggested components, and also can do simulations. And it's very useful for you to validate different component choices. So let's go to the LTM file of the schematic. This is the schematic in LTM. As you can see, for the main power components, we select the 10 microhenry inductors. And for the coupling cap, there's a 4.7 microfarad ceramic caps. And also we select the switching FET and diode has high enough voltage rating and current rating. The controller's circuitry around the 3481 is selected based on the suggestion from the Webbench. One thing to note that is I put the Zener clamp diodes on the UVRO pin to protect it in case for the input voltage to go too high. Also on this schematic, there's an optional input filter section to suppress the EMI noise from the SEPIC converter. The filter section include a LC differential mode filter and a common mode choke. Next, let's look at the layout. So for this SEPIC layout, the main power components and the main power path include the couple inductor, the diode, the coupling capacitors, and the switching FETs. They are placed separate from the LM3481 controller and the controller circuit. And for the placement, the critical current path, it's the loop formed by the diode, the FET, and the coupling cap. As you can see, I put there in a very compact loop size. And the optional EMI filter section, it's on the back of the board. So next, let's look at the actual reference board. So this is the circuit board. As you can see, we achieve a compact solution size about 24 by 30 millimeter. Here is the input terminals, and this is the couple inductor, this is the couple capacitor, this is the diode, and this is the switch FET. And this is the output terminals. And on the left side here, it's our LM3481 IC. Around that, it's the control circuitry. So if we want to include the optional EMI filter, on the left here, it's the input terminals for the EMI filter. let's look at the back of the reference board. So this is the EMI filter section. We have the differential LC filter here and the common mode choke here. And let's look at the performance of this reference design. So on this page, it shows the power efficiency. As you can see, it can achieve a wide range of operation. We tested from 4.5 volts to 20 volts, and it achieved a 92% peak efficiency. And the next one is showing the conductive EMI scan with the EMI filter on the board. So we test the EMI noise. We do the EMI scan using the CISPR-25 standard, which is an automotive EMI standard. On the left side, it's a frequency scan result from 150 kHz to 30 MHz. And on the right side, it's from 30 MHz to 108 MHz, covering the full frequency range. And the yellow chase, it's the peak detector EMI noise. And the blue one, it's the average result. On the screen, there's some red lines which represent the CISPR-25 class 5 limit lines. As you can see, our EMI scan results are all lower than the required class 5 limit lines. So this design with the EMI filter is compliant with the CISPR-25 conductive EMI standard. So today, I give you an introduction on the SEPIC converter and how to design it with the LM3481 controller. As you can see, we can achieve compact size and high efficiency using the SEPIC topology. For more information, you can visit the links on the screen. And thanks for watching.